Can you believe this man is so full of himself? He actually pulled up to the mall.
I won't wear it, nobody else will.
I'll wear your shirts, babe.
Isn't that so fucking...
So, funny story. I kind of told myself I was going to vlog on this trip, and I've been here 12 hours or so, give or take. I haven't really been vlogging, but hey, look who I'm with.
You got the wings.
Look at the camera. Look at this. It's stupid.
Bro, why are you built like Kevin Durant? What the fuck?
Yeah, they brought me out to this, what's this place called?
True Food.
Yeah.
And it's funny because we were just talking about
lobster and filet mignon tacos, which you're going to have in a couple days. Because he has to have that before he leaves.
Yeah, you just live a different life, I guess, when you...
No, you have to try it. It's like the greatest taco of all.
I believe you. I'm just saying, like, I'm used to, like I said, them soft shell tacos from Taco Bell for $1.19. That's
it. Yeah, but you're in California, huh?
Yeah.
It's like, it's different.
Yeah, you're with the guy
who ate a $70 burger once.
I don't talk about that.
It was trash though, right?
it was so good. Yeah, it was good.
Look into the camera and tell me how good it was.
It was hot. It was.
It was medium well,
like I asked.
You're not looking into the camera.
Truffles taste like paper. I'm gonna say it.
Anyway,
it's not important.
Y'all might not know this, but I'm actually like the world's pickiest eater. Like, so they all out here with some. They're out here with like some grass-fed burgers and shit with mushrooms and sauteed onions and fucking arugula and shit. I don't fucking know. I was like, yeah, let me just get like the burger like on the bun and like that's...
I don't fuck with arugula, so I'm with you on that one. That shit tastes like hardcore grass. She's like, it tastes good. Like, no, it tastes literally just harder version of lettuce.
You look like you
I don't know
arugula.
What the fuck that is.
It's like the only leafy green.
You got bread and meat.
the patty is the burger.
No.
Get off me. Anyway, yeah, vlogging. Your boy's not very good at that. But hey, look, yeah! We got the nigga Vocal Pineapple. We got Truth.
What's good?
What's good with y'all? This nigga Afro's trying to find out where his room and shit is right now. But we got that nigga Mystic up there.
Hey, what's good, everybody?
Dude, that nigga Afro.
Damn, I'm black.
Big as shit.
I'm black as fuck.
All you see is my glasses.
You are. But yeah, so it's the second right now. So Anime Expo, I think, doesn't even start till the fourth. So we basically just gonna be chilling for the rest of the night, and tomorrow I don't know what we're gonna get into, you know, some.
Fuck your vlog,
bitch! Man, fuck! Yeah, I don't know what type of shit we gonna get into tomorrow, but we, you know what I'm saying, we just gonna be on bullshit, cause that's just what we do, you feel me?
Yeah, what's good, everybody? So what is it now? The morning of the 3rd, it is 8:39 in the morning, and I believe the only ones awake right now are, me and Vocal Pineapple, Fabian. I think Yonko Productions, he's gonna be here today. He should be here maybe like an hour or so. You got Fabian over here, my nigga's up bright early.
Hey, what's good?
But
it's early.
Yeah, I think I had to defrost this one. I slept on the couch, right? Which is no big deal. And I can sleep on the floor
from
right
here. Older.
Yeah. The worst part about it is we did not specifically, I did not properly prepare, even though I knew I was going to have my own room here. It wasn't a problem. I didn't bring, like, or buy pillows or blankets. So your boy slept on the couch last night with no blanket.
The plan is to go watch Spider-Man at some point today.
Bad. So we waiting on a couple of our niggas to show up. We gonna hit up the theater. We're going to see Spider-Man. Probably going to grab some food, hit the store and shit. And, yeah.
Damn, it's mad heads and all these niggas ugly as hell. That's crazy. But I think we finally got the whole gang here. We got Afro big head ass over here. We got Truth in the back.
What's good?
Mystic over here, you know what I'm saying?
Yo, Truth is exposing the tea, dog. You better be cutting shit out.
What you mean? Exposing the tea? How you figure?
Nah, you didn't hear it, so sorry.
I didn't hear it. We got that nigga Yonko in the cut, you feel me? That's a scary sight. That nigga Reek would have pulled up to this bitch, you feel me? And we got that nigga Testar. Boy, it's my motherfucking boy. But yeah, these niggas gotta go pick up their badges and shit for the expo. Afro and I and Yonko about to go link up with some other homies, Damo, Tag, and whoever else is at their B&B, I don't know, but we gonna kick it there for a minute. Still working on this vlog and shit, cause I'm not accustomed to this, but I promise y'all, I'm gonna have a video to show by the end of it. It may not be the most well put together organized one, but there will be a blog of some sort. But yeah. up to a Nike store. I was trying to grab a few things. We get him some new shoes. Something, you know, you had to get the drip right for the trip. You feel me? Oh yeah. By the way, we just pulled out from an Airbnb where my niggas Damo and Tiger and them niggas was at. Shit. Shout out to Tiger for the $20. He had the audacity to bet on his homie Greed against me in a money match of fighters. You know I wasn't going outside, so you know I had to hit him with a quick 3-0, collect my coin, secure the bag on vacation. You know how we rocking. I'm my man Yonko in the cut. It's good, it's good. Alright, for over here getting his little vlog thing going on. You feel me?
Are you done talking?
Nah, I'm not. Nah, but I just thought I'd give y'all a little update. But yeah, we're gonna hit this Nike spot real quick.
So we in the outlet right now. Afro's over here. He's looking to get him, you know, a little black and red joints or something like that. Speaking of black and red though, I wasn't a huge fan of these when they came out, to be honest. Like, I don't dislike them, but it definitely wasn't a pickup that I thought I needed. But they're sitting here in the outlet and like, I don't know, bro. You know, I'm the king of making bad decisions and buying shit that I don't really need when it comes to sneakers. And y'all know how I am with Jordan 1s. Like, if you know about me, you know, like, half my collection is Jordan 1s. So, them is looking kind of hard. And they also, I seen they got the Tinker 3s over here, too. And I'm just like, damn. See, they don't carry stuff like this at my outlet back home. No. And they got some, I forget what it's called. I think it's like the Nostalgia Flight 9s or something like that. But, yeah, they don't really carry the good stuff back in my list. It's a refreshing change of pace. I think I've seen, oh yeah, the Chlorfield 3s. A lot of niggas sleep on these, and I don't really know why, because I think this color was like really clean. These actually were back at my outlet at home. But yeah, I'm looking around. I didn't have intentions on buying anything when I walked in here, but we're gonna see. What do I got to lose, you know what I mean?
It's windy and shit. Alright, so little known fact about me, very, very few people know about this, because I don't know if I've ever really talked about it publicly, because it's not like it's a big deal, right? But there's one restaurant I've seen all over social media for like the last 2 years that I don't have anywhere near me, so I've never gotten a chance to try. And I just want you to say, don't let your dreams be dreams. Dreams really do come true. I'm going to eat some Raising Cane's today.
You know what? I'm going to just take his footage. You know what? I'm going to just use your footage.
I got you.
So check me out. So I finally get to try it for the first time. You ready? Y'all get to experience this with me. Alright.
It's alright.
This shit is fucking great. It's every bit as good as I hoped it would be. To me, that was better than KFC, that's better than Zaxby's, and it was better than Popeyes. Hold that.
Hold up. Chick-fil-A. Better Chick-fil-A. Okay. The review has been sent. It's recorded. What y'all think about that?
I just want you guys to know, I walked into that establishment a boy, and I emerged as a fucking man. Oh, all right, so I know y'all can't see shit right now, but we're currently in the theater, getting ready to watch Spider-Man. That's gonna be interesting for me because I ain't see Homecoming, so watching Far From Home. Nah, cause I don't really go to the theater like that. I'm a weeb. I only go to the theater to see anime movies.
I'm gonna tell you, like, this Homecoming, Dragon Ball Super, but nothing else I saw before then.
Yep.
Maybe Dark Crisis. I was so mad. I'm like, bro, like, I had to pee.
But yeah, it's gonna be interesting. So
they did.
We're gonna do that. What's what do we think, boys? What do we think?
Yo, that's the good question. What do we think about the movie?
Yeah.
Fucking lit!
Lit! Lit time!
Listen, I'm not really big on like Marvel movies. I don't really care a lot about superheroes. I didn't even watch Homecoming, but I'm not going front. That shit was kind of him. If Tom Holland touches Zendaya again, I'm going to beat his ass though. I'm going to pull up on that nigga.
Bro, in the middle of this movie,
So I'm here today with the boy Riku. Riku the best. You already know the rest of Dark Knight in the building. You know what I'm saying? We got that boy Mystic Watch still over here.
Hey, what's good?
Baby and Tech over here. You already know what's going on. We got Truth. That's good. You know what I'm saying? He's been out here slimming down, by the way. That boy been losing weight. Might have been cheating a little bit out here, but we on vacation.
Hello? That shit smell like a vlog, nigga. You know what today is? Today's we wild out. We flex on these niggas.
We going crazy, going stupid.
With clout, yeah.
Oh, and before I forget, y'all gotta peep the sauce, bro. Okay, you know your boy gotta get right about here. You see that? Yeah, you know how we're moving. Well, we have officially made it here, and now it's time to get lost in the sauce.
I'm
up against? Do you want Greninja?
I want Greninja. I want Greninja. No, no, no. Greninja?
Which one do you
give
want?
Give me Greninja, all right? When I beat him, you can give me Cloud if you want to, all right?
When you beat
and
him.
And then when I beat Cloud, it's whatever you want to do for your mental health. You know?
Are you going to be alive in 40 years? You sweating a lot, bro.
I can't help you it. Like, how fast do you want to lose?
Yeah, day three Anime Expo. Right now I'm with the boys.
Day three.
Riku, that boy Mystic in the cut.
Good. You good for today?
So Fabian and, what was came? Fabian and Yonko. It was just them two. Yeah, they're already here. They got wristbands to go see the premiere for My Hero. We did not, so we came a little later. Afro, Truth, and Tech are back at the B&B. They were still asleep when we left, but we decided we was going to go ahead and come in since Yonko and Fabian finished watching My Hero and shit. And yeah, so it's day three. I didn't actually do a whole lot of vlogging inside the convention yesterday. Detours. But anyway, like I was saying, didn't do a lot of vlogging inside the convention yesterday, but I'm going to try my best to do it today, especially because I'll probably be here. Today will probably be the day I spend the most time here, so it's the earliest that I've gotten here. I'll probably spend the most time here today. Probably also going to make some bad decisions today, so we're going to see what we're going to get into. At Kino, I bought some Hooli Cooli posters, a t-shirt. They had the Shaman King character book that I couldn't pass up. Now, link back up with Yonko. We got the boy Riku. You see Boca Pineapple back there. Mystic and the boys. Afro still has not woken up to my knowledge, so we just hear mobbing without him, but we'll probably link up the
shirt. Team Lotus, yeah!
So now we're trying to find this low-key something or other booth, and that's the move right here. Notice how the Anime Expo lanyard just like blends right in with the shirt. That shit kind of fire, I ain't even gonna hold you. But you see the sauce, you see the homemade Lotus House Support bracelets, and you see, had to break out the bread folds today for the first time. You feel me? So that's the sauce for today. You know what's crazy? I thought I had mastered the art of how to tame my hair prior to this trip, but I feel like I've had a bad hair day every day since I've been out here. That aside though, currently at the Bandai booth, we're waiting on Afro to finally pull up and meet us here. I don't know what the plan is now. I guess we're waiting on Afro and then we're gonna go grab something to eat. I think I still have a couple more spots I'm trying to hit. Since I'm already this deep in, I'm gonna spend some more money because I like making bad decisions and I like not being able to eat for 2 weeks. So yeah, that's the plan. Also, we've seen a lot of dope cosplays. I got a lot of really cool pictures that I'm looking forward to getting back to the B&B so I can edit them on my computer and shit. But yeah, the convention's been dope. Convention has been dope. Yeah, so Afro is finally joined, so I guess we're probably gonna go grab something to eat. I'm not really sure, but we'll see what the day holds for us. Cause it's still early. It's only like 2:00, so the day is young. The day is very young. All right, so now we're in the entertainment hall. You know, truth be told, the last 2 days I didn't even make my way to this side of the convention because I didn't know it was here. I'ma just keep it a buck. We got the boy Damo in the cut. That's a scary sight.
I just saw Harada. It was lit. He was outside.
Lucky bastard. This side of the convention is actually pretty cool because for some reason it just feels like there's way more space in here. I guess this is because like the exhibition hall is like where it's the most populated. That and the artist alley, right? But it's like they got a lot of gaming and stuff going on here. Like they have arcade cabinets, which is pretty dope. I might scope around see if they got like Tekken or something over there because y'all know the boy like Tekken. So we still mobbing, just wandering around, just seeing what we're getting into. Just having a good time. So your boy found the fighter setup, and I may or may not have sat down and bullied some people for half an hour without dropping a single game. I mean, who's to say? All I'm saying is that if you've seen a boy who goes by the alias of Lotus Asakura, the Hanakage of Hanagakure, with the flower t-shirt on, I'm just saying, you know, that might have been me that beat your ass. I'm just saying.
And now I'm back home. I know that was a really terrible place to cut the video, but hopefully you guys still enjoyed it. I tried to include as much as I could. Again, vlogging is still something that's very new to me, and it's something that I am going to do my best to work on and improve, and it's something I want to do more of in the future. That being said, I think one thing I do need to invest in is a newer, better phone or a separate camera for vlogging, because the quality just ain't up to my standard. But again, I do think people will enjoy this video anyway, so that's why I'm gonna put it out anyway. But yeah, I'm gonna improve it in the future. I want to do more traveling, I want to do more vlogs. With any luck, I will actually be attending Evo next month, so here's hoping with that. Wish me luck. I am gonna compete, don't expect to make it very far. But it's just gonna be a fun experience. I do want to vlog that as well. Hopefully I'll be out there with Rhyme Style and Afro Senju, so that'll be another good time, and potentially another video for me to upload, another vlog for me to upload. And yeah, I mean, I had a great time at Anime Expo. I had a great time in LA hanging out with all the homies. I hope to do it again next year. It was a blast, man. What can I say? But yeah, I'm a mess. I'm trying to wrap up this vlog. I just needed something at the end because I kind of ended off my vlogging footage at a weird spot. So yeah, I'm gonna get up out of here. Like I said, I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and look forward to potentially more vlogs in the future. So hit this video like if you enjoyed it. Subscribe if you haven't already, so you can stay tuned for all this content I'm gonna bring you. And with all that being said, that's Rich off today, and remember, nothing can happen to you swing the bat. Later.